Hello and welcome to Kuala Lumpur International Airport. I've been to Malaysia quite a few times in the past, but I never get to fly with Malaysia Airlines. This morning, thanks to Oman Air, I'm finally going to fly with them to Bali Denpasar on Airbus A330 aircraft. Hopefully, it's going to be a great experience. Let's go! Welcome to Malaysia. I arrived here 12 hours ago after flying with Oman Air. As I booked both the Oman Air and the Malaysia Airlines flight under the same PNR, my bag was through-checked from Muscat to Bali. This allowed me to stay within the transit area and skip the immigration. Kuala Lumpur International Airport is Malaysia's main international airport, situated roughly 45 kilometers south of the city. It served more than 62 million passengers in 2019, making it the 21st busiest airport globally. The airport has two terminals. Terminal 2, also known as KLIA2, is a purpose-built terminal for budget airlines. It's a hub for AirAsia and AirAsia X. The main terminal building, also known as KLIA Main or KLIA1, along with a satellite terminal, handles most of the airport's domestic and international flights. It's the primary hub for Malaysia Airlines. As you can see, the satellite building offers a variety of amenities, including restaurants, cafes, duty-free shops, lounges, and prayer rooms. To move between the main terminal and the satellite building, passengers can ride the Aero train. The satellite building also houses a transit hotel named Sama Sama Express KLIA. Due to the confusing signage, it took me a bit of time to find it. It's actually situated just before gate C5. The hotel has 80 rooms, each with a private bathroom and a king-sized bed. My room was impeccably clean, and most importantly, it boasted a fantastic view of the apron. You can book the room for 6, 9, or 12 hours. My 12-hour stay cost me 386 Malaysian ringgit. The price is reasonable. Malaysia Airlines is a member of the One World Alliance. Its international flagship lounge is called the Golden Lounge Satellite, located above the Aerotrain platforms. This lounge complex is shared between first class and business class passengers, with the entry to the first class lounge on the right and the business class lounge on the left. Flying in business class tomorrow gives me access to the business lounge. Being a Qantas Platinum frequent flyer with One World Emerald status, I have access to the first class lounge as well. Although not overly spacious, the lounge features plenty of comfortable seating and stunning apron views during the day. The self-serve counter provides alcoholic beverages, soft drinks, water, coffee, and tea. Other amenities include toilets, prayer rooms, a napping area, and individual shower suites. There's no food available in the main seating area. Instead, there's a small restaurant offering a la carte dining. Featuring only 13 tables in this room, the space fills up quickly. During my visit, I had to wait for half an hour before finally securing a table. While the menu is not the most extensive, it still offers several options for each course. To start, I opted for their signature oxtail soup. And I must say, it was worth my half an hour wait to get in here. The broth was rich and flavorful, and the meat on the oxtail was tender. Malaysians are known for their skill in cooking chicken. It is a staple protein in Malaysian cuisine. For my main course, I chose the boneless roasted chicken, which had crispy skin and moist meat. Both the chicken and the noodles below were complemented by the tangy and slightly spicy mustard sauce. This is another flavorful dish. The chicken alone was already very filling, therefore I decided to skip the dessert. In general, what I appreciate about the first class lounge is its peaceful atmosphere and the a la carte menu that showcases local Malaysian cuisine. Now, let's take a look at the business class lounge. Passengers with a business class ticket from any Oneworld airline and Oneworld Sapphire tiered frequent flyers flying in economy can enter this lounge free of charge. This place is much larger than the first class lounge. I was particularly impressed by the food selections here. While it may not offer the fine dining experience of the first class lounge next door, the buffet is expansive and varied. The menu changes seasonally. It typically features local Malaysian dishes such as nasi lemak, chicken satay, curry laksa, and beef rendang, and international options like salads, sandwiches, soups, and pasta dishes. In addition, there's an assortment of cakes, pastries, and fresh fruit. After a few hours of decent sleep, I checked out of my hotel room and returned to the Golden Lounge for a quick breakfast before my flight. I went directly to the business lounge this time, as it had a more comprehensive food selection. Although it was busier than the previous night, I was still able to find an empty table. By the way, the business lounge also has napping rooms, prayer rooms, and showers. As of November 2022, Malaysia Airlines has a fleet of 69 aircraft, comprising of 42 Boeing 737-800, 6 A350-900, 15 A330-300, and 6 A330-200. At the time of filming, the airline operates 3 daily flights between Kuala Lumpur and Denpasar, utilizing a combination of Boeing 737 and A330 aircraft. Similar to Singapore Changi Airport, security screening is carried out at the boarding gate, so please make sure you allocate sufficient time for boarding. My flight this morning is operated by an Airbus A330-300, which features 27 business class and 263 economy class seats.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is a boarding announcement for Malaysia Airlines Flight MH715 bound to Denpasar. Please ready your boarding pass for verification. Now we invite business class passenger may board the aircraft through door A.
Malaysia Airlines uses Thomson Aero's Vantage model business seats on the A330 and A350s. They are arranged in a combination of 122 and 121 configurations.
Good morning.
The seats on the right-hand side of the cabin are all single, those in the middle are double, and those on the left are a mix of single and double seats. Additionally, there are two rows of 242 configured extra legroom economy class seats behind the business class cabin before door 2. I particularly like this seat design as it caters to both solo travelers and couples. For this flight, I selected seat 6K, which is a throne seat. There is a lot more surface space around my seat compared to the double seats behind. Once I had taken my seat, the cabin crew offered me a glass of juice and a cold towel. Moments later, the cabin manager walked to every seat and greeted everyone by their last names. There are 2 lavatories assigned for the 27 business passengers. Despite the short flight, each lavatory is stocked with body and hand lotion, eau de toilette, and toothpicks.
If there's a drop in cabin pressure, an oxygen mask will automatically appear in front of you.
Kuala Lumpur International Airport has three runways, and today we'll be using the east runway. Now let's take a closer look at my seat. I noticed a coat hook situated beside the entertainment screen. There are several storage places surrounding the seat, including a spacious area under the window enough to fit my camera bag and provided blanket. On the opposite side of my seat, there's a hidden compartment with a vanity mirror. There are two control panels for adjusting the seat's position, activating the massage function, and turning on the overhead reading light. Adjacent to the armrest, there's a USB port, a headphone jack, a remote for the entertainment screen, and an adjustable reading light. A universal power socket and a safety card holder are positioned near my leg. The seat has a width of 20 inches, which is on the narrower side, and the pitch is 43 inches. Overall, while Malaysia Airlines' Vantage-based seats are not the most luxurious option on the market, they do offer all the features that a business traveler would anticipate. The product ticked all my boxes. Shortly after takeoff, the crew commenced lunch service. A menu was handed to me when the plane was on the ground. There are three choices for the main course, and I opted for the nasi lemak. As of 2020, the estimated Muslim population in Malaysia is 63.5%. Although there aren't any alcoholic beverages listed on the menu, a bottle of red, white, and champagne were displayed on the drink trolley. Accompanying the main course were a selection of pastries, including crustless white toast, croissant, and banana cake. The champagne served on board was produced by Philipona. It has a retail price of $82 per bottle in Australia. Nasi lemak is often considered the national dish of Malaysia. It is a popular meal enjoyed at any time of the day. The dish typically comes with cucumber slices, a hard-boiled egg, fried anchovies, and roasted peanuts. The proteins in the dish can be varied, but chicken, beef, and prawns are typically the most common options. A spicy chili paste known as sambal is added to enhance the dish's flavor. The prawns are big and tasted fresh and succulent. However, the highlight of the meal was undoubtedly the sambal, which boasted a perfect blend of spicy, sweet, and savory flavors. Pairing the rice with the sauce was simply delectable. Instead of using the boiled egg, Malaysia Airlines used the omelette, which was nothing special. In general, I was absolutely delighted with the dish. I have no doubt that this is the most delicious nasi lemak one could have in the air. Let's have a look at the in-flight entertainment system. In the pocket below, there is a very basic noise-cancelling headphone. The 16-inch HD screen is a touch screen, and you can also control it with a remote. The system is available in both English and Malay, and offers a decent selection of movies, including recent releases and TV shows. And of course, you can check out the flight path as well. We are currently just 57 minutes from Denpasar, and the plane will begin its descent in less than 20 minutes. As expected, each seat can be converted into a fully flat bed. The bed length is 76 inches, which should be long enough for most people. The biggest drawback of my throne seat is its narrow foot nook compared to other business class seats, resulting in limited space for foot movement while lying down. Despite this, this bed is still relatively comfortable for those flying long haul. In summary, this flight was fantastic. While their business class seats may not be the latest and the greatest, from ample storage space and power outlets to a comfortable lie flat bed and direct aisle access, the seat still has everything I needed. What impressed me the most, however, was Malaysia Airlines' exceptional soft product. The crew members were all friendly, professional and energetic, with smiles on their faces throughout the flight. And let's not forget about the Golden Lounge in Kuala Lumpur, which is undoubtedly one of the best airport lounges in Southeast Asia.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Muara Rai International Airport, Denpasar. It's been our pleasure serving you. Thank you for flying Malaysia Airlines, a member of One World Alliance, and we hope you have enjoyed our Malaysian hospitality. Thank you.
The crew disarmed doors and cross-check. Thank you.
Thank you for joining me on this flight to Denpasar, Indonesia. I hope you found this review informative and enjoyable. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more flight and train reviews. In my next video, I will be in Yerevan, Armenia, taking a journey on a state-of-the-art Russian-built night train from Armenia across to Georgia. Stay tuned and see you then.